Started a long time ago when I was a student at the same college, in fact, as the Martindale Quartet, Royal Northern College of Music. I left and went into profession, started performing, and I had, very early on, as I was performing as a conductor, I had a question that became increasingly important to me, which was, how is it that we musicians in the profession, how do we give our best performances? How do we arrive at the performances that really catch light, that take off, that really, if you feel really grab the audience, grab everybody else, and take everybody, to sort of some extraordinary level. I'm sure all of you have experienced those performances, those special ones. And I became fascinated by them because I thought, well, the purpose of my job, often when you're working with certainly professional orchestras in this country, you're not really trying to sort of deal with technical problems because they can play pretty much everything. Most of what you're doing is working on musical things. So, the notes themselves, people can play. What you're really trying to do is to find a way of bringing the performance to life. I think it's much more like being an actor in a way. All actors can speak. What a director's job is to bring it to life and to make it believable. And that felt to me as if it was the central goal of what I needed to do as a conductor. And I found it very difficult. In fact, for several years, I think about 5 or 6 years, deep inside my mind, that was always at the back of what a rehearsal was for, this a journey to try and find these performances. And sometimes I succeeded, and sometimes I didn't. And then, about 6 years into my career, I'd say, roughly, I had a sort of eureka moment, which was very strange. I was sitting at home, playing the piano, idly. You know the Lost Chord, that famous C.D. Mm-hmm. I'm sure some of you must know that song. Wonderful Victorian song, which I'm going to know. It's rather like that. I was sitting at the piano playing individual notes, and suddenly I became aware that I could feel the different pitches, the different notes that I was playing in different parts of my body. And that was very odd.
And somebody came around in a black coat.
I was very surprised by this. For a number of minutes, I repeated the process, and I found that it seemed to be stable, and I was feeling higher notes higher up, lower notes lower down, little notes in the middle, which is exactly what you've just been doing. On the website, we ask people to do that. We've done this in many other circumstances as well. But I became fascinated by this. And I think the first thing that occurred to me was that quality of feeling of pitch that I was getting reminded me strongly of these peak experiences, these emotionally engaged experiences that I was having as a performer on occasion. So my question was to myself was, well, this thing seems to work. What do I do with this? It seems to be related to peak performances, but what do I do next with it?
Now, a lot of people hearing that would think, well, naturally, what makes players play exceptionally well is an emotional engagement which comes from the head and what they're experiencing and how they feel about a piece, not literally how they feel the piece as in their toes or their heads.
It's a very complicated thing, and the whole process of how music and how music triggers emotional responses from us is quite complex. There's so many factors that interact. But what I was doing, I think, what I found at this point was that something that seemed to be one of the conditions, or one of the things that was always there for me when I was having a strong experience. So I suppose, like a lot of things to do with research, you often start with yourself as the subject, and I sort of continued on from that, because as I'm a conductor, I'm constantly working with other people and trying to draw performances from them and then come in with different ideas about how to do that. And I very quickly started using this technique, if you like, as one of the sort of weapons in my armoury. This was what excited me, is that I knew that, again, from talking to people and from my own experiences, that I think when we have these powerful emotional experiences of music, we expect there to be physical things going on. Perhaps you could say that of emotion in general. For any of us to say, I am in the grip of a strong emotion, we would expect there to be physical things going on. We'd expect to be palpitations, breathing rates change, all these things, and of course endocrine system, the sense of hormones rushing around our bodies, which would lead to the hairs at the back of the neck sticking up, or butterflies in the tummy. I mean, it's common So this, I think this is what excited me, is this idea of the physicality of sound.